Hello learners, welcome to our Environmental Science Senior Secondary course of NIOS. Earlier we have studied on different sources of water, importance of fresh water, as without which there would be no life on earth. We have already discussed about groundwater and fresh water resources, its use and significance of maintaining the quality of fresh water. We need to conserve the water for the present and for the future generations. During this program, we will discuss about methods of rainwater harvesting. For this, I, Dr. Rita Khosla, Associate Professor, retired Zakharovsen Delhi College, University of Delhi, welcome you all to this program. Water scarcity is threatening to assume alarming proportions world over. In India, thousands of villages are without regular sources of drinking water. Women and children walk long distances every day to carry meager amount of water. So, the objective of this program are: describe the need and importance of water conservation, explain the need for water harvesting, categorize and describe different methods of traditional water harvesting, categorize and describe different methods of modern water harvesting. Now, what is the need for water conservation? Water is the most essential natural resource for life, and there is no substitute for water. It is likely to become a scarce resource in many regions of the world in the coming decades. We need to develop water harvesting system for India's water security and overall sustainable development. Water scarcity is further intensified by human activities. In our day-to-day life, we use more water than is required during bathing and other domestic uses. Water is wasted by leaking taps and overflowing water tanks. Also, there are numerous interstate and international conflicts for water going on all over the world because it is becoming a scarce resource. Total fresh water and sea water of the earth is essentially fixed. About 97.3% of water is found in oceans, and this salt water cannot be used for human consumption, irrigation or industries. Out of the 2.7% of fresh water, 1.98%, that is nearly 2%, is locked in ice caps, so very little fresh water is available for our daily consumption. India is one of the wettest country in the world. However, uneven distribution of rainfall in different states of India results in severe water scarcity. On an average, it receives about 1150 millimeters of rainfall annually, which is highest in the world for a country of similar size. However, the average number of rainy days in a year are only 40. Water is one of our most poorly managed resources. Chirapunji in northeast India was once the wettest place on earth. It was full of dense forests which formed rain clouds. Because of the indiscriminate cutting down of forests, the top soil is washed away by the rain and the area has become barren. As a result, villagers in Chirapunji have to get water from elsewhere. When surface water such as rivers and lakes are inadequate to meet our demand, then we have to depend on groundwater. Due to rapid urbanization and deforestation, recharging of groundwater has diminished. Excessive tapping of groundwater through numerous boreholes has led to a decline in the water table. So, there is need to conserve water for agriculture. Water conservation for agriculture. In order to increase food production, we need more and more water for irrigation. Thus, there is an urgent need for conservation of water. Depleting water table and rise in salinity due to irrigation are serious matter. In India's arid and semi-arid areas, the tank system is traditionally the backbone of agricultural production. Throughout the world, water crisis is brought about by population explosion. More the number of people, more per head requirement of water. deterioration of water quality due to pollution, disappearance of traditional tanks and ponds, rising needs of industries and agriculture for water, and climate change, which is causing drought-like conditions in many places. We have long dry period in our country, so we need to store water in lakes, reservoirs or underground. With increasing demand for water, these resources are becoming increasingly inadequate. So, efforts are being done to retain more and more rainwater for use during dry period. Rainwater harvesting at local levels are done by simple methods of expanding water supply. The most important step in the direction of water conservation is to change people's attitudes and habits. If the world continues to treat water as a cheap resource that could be wasted, then not even the best policies and technologies can help to solve water scarcity. It is estimated that by the year 2050, half of India's population will be living in urban areas and will face acute water problems. The augmentation of groundwater by rainwater harvesting is a need of the hour. It is an old technology gaining popularity in a new way. We will now discuss traditional methods of water harvesting in our next section. Traditional methods of water harvesting. Let's see the history first. Practice of rainwater harvesting was started during biblical times at around 4000 years ago in Palestine and Greece. In ancient Rome, residences were built with individual cisterns and paved courtyard to capture rainwater. As early as the 3rd millennium BC, farming communities in Balochistan and Kutch collected rainwater and used it for irrigation. Here you can see picture of rainwater harvesting in traditional way in ponds, lake, tanks and recharging in groundwater. Now let's see the rainwater harvesting in ancient India. Ancient religious texts of India gives an idea into the water storage and conservation system that prevailed in those days. In ancient India, people believed that forests were the mothers of rivers and they worshipped the sources of these water bodies. In forests, water seeps gently into the ground and this groundwater in turn feeds wells, lakes and rivers. The Indus Valley civilization that flourished along the banks of the river Indus along western and northern India above 5000 years ago had sophisticated sewage system. These people were well acquainted with hygiene, which can be seen from the covered drains running beneath the streets of the ruins of both Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. In ancient times, houses in parts of western Rajasthan were built with rooftop water harvesting system. Another very good example is the city of Dholavaras in Gujarat. Each fort in the area had its own water harvesting and storage system in the forms of tanks and wells, and they are still being used today. A large number of forts in Raigarh had tanks that supplied water. Underground baked earthen pipes and tunnels to transport water to distant places are still functional at Bohanpur in Madhya Pradesh, Golconda and Bijapur in Karnataka and Aurangabad in Maharashtra. In this figure, you can see that in Singhabad fort, cut out water cistern with dressed stone walls are used to store water. Jai Talyas in Uttar Pradesh, Haveli system in Madhya Pradesh and Ahar in Bihar are also methods of storing rainwater. One of the oldest water harvesting system is found about 130 km from Pune along Nainighat in the Western Ghats. A large number of tanks were cut in the rocks to provide drinking water to tradesmen. Large bund to create reservoir known as Khadin and other methods was applied to check water loss and store runoff. Now we will discuss modern methods of water harvesting. There are two main techniques of rainwater harvesting. First, storage of rainwater on surface for future use, and second, recharge to groundwater. Storage of rainwater on surface is a traditional technique and structure used as tanks, ponds, check dams, etc. Recharge to groundwater is a new concept of rainwater harvesting, and the structure generally used are pits. Recharge pits are constructed for recharging the shallow aquifer. Now, what is the aquifer? It is a porous water saturated layers of sand, gravel or bedrock that can yield significant or usable amount of water. They are constructed 1 to 2 meter wide, 1 to 1.5 meter deep, which are backfilled with boulders, gravels, coarse sand. Now, in this figure we can see the water from rooftop is collected in recharge pit where boulders and charcoal filter the water. So, on top we see the arrow, and there is a mesh there which is not letting debris like leaf come in the water, and then the water goes down the downspout, and on the downspout also there is a screen to remove the pollutants, and the gutters take the water to the filter tank which is shown below, and from this filter where you have boulders and gravel to filter the water, pollutants from the water, and it is going down into the recharge pit and it will be stored there. Trenches, they are constructed when the permeable rock is available at shallow depth. These are backfilled with filter materials. Dug wells, existing dug wells may be utilized as recharge structures, and water should pass through filter media before putting into the dug well. Hand pumps. The existing hand pumps may be used for recharging the shallow deep aquifers if the availability of water is limited. Water should pass through the filter media to avoid choking of recharge wells. Now, what are recharge wells? They are of 100 to 300 millimeter diameter, are generally constructed for recharging the deeper aquifers, and water is passed through the filter media to avoid choking of recharge wells. Recharge shafts. For recharging the shallow aquifer which is located below the clay surface, recharge shafts are constructed and backfilled with boulders, gravel and coarse sand. Next is lateral shafts with bore wells. For recharging the upper as well as deeper aquifer, lateral shafts are used and for water, and one or two bores well is constructed. The lateral shaft is backfilled with boulders, gravel and coarse sand. Next, we will discuss about diversion of runoff water into existing surface water bodies and its benefits. Construction activity in around a city is resulting in drying up of water bodies and reclamation of these tanks for conversion into plots for houses. Free flow of storm runs off into the tanks and water bodies can be used as harvesting system. The storm runoff may be diverted into the nearest tanks or depression, which will create additional recharge. In urban areas, the construction of houses, footpaths and roads has left little exposed earth for water to soak in. In parks of the rural areas of India, flood water quickly flows to the rivers, which then dry up soon once the rain stops. If this water can be held back and allowed to seep into the ground for recharging the groundwater supply, this becomes a very popular method of conserving water, especially in the urban areas. Rainwater harvesting essentially means collecting rainwater on the roof of a building and storing it underground for later use. Realizing the importance of recharging groundwater, the Government of India and many state governments, many NGOs and other institutions are taking steps to encourage rainwater harvesting in the country. Town planners and civic authority are introducing bylaws making rainwater harvesting compulsory in new buildings. For that, the bylaw is: no water or sewage connection would be given if a new building did not have provision for rainwater harvesting. Some of the benefits of rainwater harvesting are as follows: increases water availability, checks the declining water table, it is environment friendly, improves the quality of groundwater through dilution of fluoride, nitrate and salinity, prevents soil erosion and flooding, especially in urban areas. There are several case studies regarding rainwater harvesting. We will take one or two during this program. Rainwater harvesting, a success story in River Rupel in Rajasthan, receives very little rainfall. The water level in the river began declining due to extensive deforestation and agricultural activities along the banks, and by the year 1980s, a drought-like situation was seen. The women of the area took the initiative of building johads, round ponds and dams to hold back rainwater. You can see the figure showing a round pond. Now, due to water conservation, water is available throughout the year in this area. Second case study is related to rainwater harvesting at Rashtrapati Bhavan, which was done by Center for Science and Environment, CSE, a New Delhi based NGO. CSE recommends the revival of traditional water harvesting system along the modern technologies. In 1998, the then President of India asked Center for Science and Environment to design rainwater harvesting system in Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi. The presidential estate is a large area and receives water around 800 million liters per year in the form of rainfall. Rainwater from the rooftop and paved areas surrounding Rashtrapati Bhavan is diverted to underground storage tank for low quality use. Water passing into a recharge well is passed through a desilting tank to remove pollutants. CSE also helped rainwater harvesting in schools under Green School program to drain water from lawns. In this figure, you can see that excess water from rain and lawns is going into the square bores or the holes which are there, and from there the water goes underground and is not wasted. Some of the initiatives by CSE for rainwater harvesting are colonies, Vasant Kunj, Delhi, apartments, Surya Vihar, institution, Ford Foundation, universities, Jamia Hamdard University, hospitals, spinal injury center, industries, Hero Honda, Haryana, slums, Naka Gate slum, Bhubaneswar. Mr. Rajinder Singh, a well-known water conservationist from Rajasthan and also known as Waterman of India, he runs an NGO called Tarun Bharat Sangh. He has solved the water problem in Rajasthan to a large extent by using the technique of rainwater harvesting. His methods helped in preventing floods, restored soil and brought back wildlife. Details will be discussed in lesson 31 of this module. Now we would like to discuss about rainwater harvesting at household level. Now imagine this is a household. All you need for water harvesting system is a rain and a place to collect it. Rain is collected on rooftops and other surfaces, and the water is carried down to where it can be used immediately or stored. You can direct water stored in plants and lawns for your use. Here you can see that the water is taken down through pipes into a tank, and from the tank it can be used for irrigation. Now this next slide also showing from rain is falling on the rooftop, then on either side there are gutters to collect the water, and from pipes it is going down. Then there is a filter pump which filters the water and pumps it, and it is collected in the tank. Now rainwater harvesting system has four main components. First is collection of rainwater. Second is storage, third is distribution, and fourth is maintenance. And in this figure, it is clear that the catchment is the first. Rainwater collection is by catchment, and conduits are taking the water down for distribution, and then it is stored there. Now the first one, rainwater, the components of rainwater harvesting system. The first is rainwater collection. catchments. The catchment of water harvesting system is a surface which directly receives the rainfall. It can be a terrace, a lawn, open ground, or any other permeable surface. A roof made of reinforced cement concrete, RCC, galvanized iron, or corrugated sheets can also be used for water collection. Next is storage. Storage system can vary in complexity and depending on one's needs. An effective system can involve a 250-liter drum fed by rooftop gutters and downspouts. Debris and leaves should be filtered before storing the water by placing screens or coarse mesh over gutters or downspouts. Water kept in tanks or systems should also be covered to minimize algal growth and eliminate the potential for mosquito breeding. Placing floating lids on storage tank is an effective solution. Next is distribution. Gutters or narrow channels which collect rainwater from the roof of a building and divert it away from the structure, typically into a drain and downspout, is a vertical pipe for carrying rainwater from rain gutter to ground level. Many people store harvested rainwater and then distribute later through their regular drip irrigation system. Filter. Now see in this figure, from the rooftop through the pipes, the water is collected and it is taken to a storage tank and then it is sent to the filter unit which is shown below. The filter is used to remove suspended pollutants from rainwater collected over roof. A filter unit is a chamber filled with filtering media such as fiber, coarse sand and gravel layers to remove added dirt from water before it enters the storage tank of recharge structure. Here you can see refilling of filter material inside recharge well. Charcoal can be also added for additional filtration as charcoal removes pollutants. Last one is system maintenance. Water harvesting system requires occasional maintenance, but this is easily accomplished. Debris, screens or over gutters should be cleaned periodically and storage tanks should be drained and cleaned when it is convenient to do so. Now, advantages of rainwater harvesting. It increases the water availabilities, raises the water level in wells and borewells, brings about improvement in quality of groundwater, and is very helpful in mitigation of the effects of drought. Rainwater harvesting system also checks the declining water table, reduces soil erosion, decreases choking of drains and flooding of roads. And so finally, we conclude that the uses of rainwater harvesting is mainly it is an environment friendly method. It improves the quality of groundwater through the dilution of fluoride, nitrate and salinity. It also saves energy because a lot of energy is used to lift groundwater to rooftop. Now, what can a common citizen do? Is rainwater harvesting and conservation of water the job of only the government and the NGOs, or can we also do something about it? We certainly can do to help in this, like do not use soap and detergent while bathing and washing in a river. Do not throw harmful chemicals, religious and other waste in river waters. And most important is do not waste water. Use only one bucket to have bath, repair leaking taps and pipes in your houses and institutes. Now let's wrap it up and recap the main points once again. What have you learned? Earth has plenty of water, but fresh water is only a small fraction of it. With growing demand for water, its resources are overexploited. Although plenty of rain occurs in India, due to its uneven distribution or over time and space, it faces severe water scarcity in its many parts. For feeding ever-growing population, India needs to grow more food grains. Developmental activities, water resources are overexploited. Since duration of rainfall is short, the agricultural activities depend on irrigation. Irrigation consumes nearly 85% of the total water used in India. With increasing demands for agriculture and other developmental activities, water resources are overexploited. Urbanization and industrialization further aggravate the situation by overexploiting and polluting the water resources. Thus, conservation is one of the most important and simple methods of water conservation. Rainwater harvesting is one of the most important and simple methods of water conservation. Rainwater harvesting is collection of rainwater and storage for direct use or for percolating into the ground to artificially recharge groundwater. Traditionally, rainwater is harvested through various means all over the world. There are evidences of rainwater harvesting in Indus Valley, Palestinian, Greek and Roman civilization. They had wisdom of conserving water. Rainwater harvesting is getting significant importance in recent past due to severe scarcity being faced in many parts of the world, including India. Several initiatives are taken by the government of India and various state governments to promote rainwater harvesting in the country. Many local bodies are considering making it mandatory to install rainwater harvesting system in housing complexes, large buildings and offices. Dear learner, this is all about lesson 30A, method of rainwater harvesting. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.